Yo, what's up? Behind me here, I have the i3, and in this video, I will show you what you have to do in order to preheat it. Now, I don't own it, I just borrow it. That's why I don't have app support, but let me show you now. It's kind of cold outside today, and the car has been sitting outside charging. Okay, all right, for you guys who don't know, under here we have the OBD port. I use OBD LX, what is calling it? OBD 2 LX. It works only for Android, but you can get similar devices. So all you have to do is plug it in and then use an app called Electrified. But right now it cannot communicate because I have to switch ignition on. Okay, let me do that. And then, okay, I think it's on now. Show i3 live data. Because I want to show you what it looks like after the car has been camped here for a while. There, okay. Outside temperature, it's interesting. Outside temperature is 10. It's actually warmer outside than inside the car right now. I don't know if you can see the inside temperature anywhere, but anyway. So the juicy stuff you want to see, okay, battery temperature is around 14 degrees Celsius, but you see, it's not pulling any power to heat up the car right now. I wonder if this is state of charge BMS. Always wonder what that is, but okay, so not pulling any power. You see, this I experienced this before, that if you just fire up the car, it doesn't really heat up the cabin. One thing you could do is when you open the door, you have this button here to activate auxiliary climate. In my previous video, I kind of made fun of the auxiliary climate, because not because I don't know what it is, I know what it is, but why did they call it auxiliary climate? Well, because it's not, the software is not fully built on electric. Auxiliary climate is something for fossil cars. I used to have a BMW 5 Series and it had auxiliary heater, it was called. It was actually a small burner that, you know, burns the diesel to heat up the engine. And well, actually the coolant, I think it was, to heat up the cabin. That was the auxiliary heater. And then also when you fire up the diesel engine, when the diesel engine is cold, it will activate auxiliary heater to quickly heat up the diesel, the coolant and the engine. So you get better working temperature and then you get better efficiency. But so why did they call it auxiliary climate here? Because they probably haven't optimized the software for electric. But anyway, too much rambling from me. So I found that one thing you could do, okay, I had to fire up the car again. And what you can do is, you see here, on the key fob, you have this custom button. And you can customize that custom button to do whatever you like. And what I've done is that I've customized it to, yeah, it's not a touchscreen. The first thing I tried was to touch it, but you have to use this iDrive here, yeah. You have to go here to, vehicle settings. And then doors key, and then here you see this custom key. You can choose it to do whatever. Let me just adjust the lights a bit. There you go, see better. I don't know what else you can use it for. Tail. Oh, the nice animation to shows you what it does. Home lights. I guess it would just flash at you. But this one is very, very useful. Auxiliary climate control. So I've set it to do that, and now I will demonstrate what it does. So if I just let me see. I think the i3 is so smart that if you just open the door, it actually stops the car. Because there is a start-stop button, but you don't always have to do it. All right, and then I lock the car. And then I will show you. It's kind of hard to show, but what the heck was that? It also happened earlier. I was just playing around and then somehow the alarm triggered. What? Why did the alarm trigger? Maybe it's intrusion alarm. No. I have no, sorry guys, I have no idea why the alarm just went there. Let me just temporarily turn it off because it maybe some of the equipment here triggers the alarm. Maybe the OBD stuff triggers it. Okay, but I don't think we need to lock it. And I just want to. Okay, I have no idea what's wrong there, but let's just do it like this. And then what you do is, you under ideal conditions, you press this one, you press and hold it, and there. Okay, I don't know if you saw it. That one started, and now we start the auxiliary heater. And this one has a heat pump, so it needs a little. Okay. And if you see here, it needs a little bit of time. Oh, oops. But now it fires up, and now it pulls power. Actually, I think it's pretty smart. It should pull power from the plug because we are plugged in. Yeah, I'm gonna check that also. We have all the stuff here we can check. You see, it was saying plus something. Now it says minus something. Interesting. Let me check, because I also have this one. The energy kick. We can connect to the energy kick and check what's going on right now. Yeah, so this is nice. You see, we are pulling power from the plug. So as long as you're plugged in and you preheat, it will pull power from the plug. I think most cars are like this, except for a few cars. I heard that e-tron struggles a little bit. If you fire up the heater, it will also fire up the battery heater. And then it will pull so much power that if you don't have powerful enough socket, it will naturally suck some power from the battery also. But right now, it's pulling 16, this is around 3 kilowatts. And we have available, we have 25 amp, you see. We're not pulling the maximum here, so we can pull about 5 kilowatt from the socket. But if you look here, we suddenly went down a little bit on state of charge. I don't know, this should mean that we are pulling, are we pulling that much? Really? Are we pulling 2.5 kilowatt from the battery? I'm still kind of new to this app, so I don't understand what the minus and the plus means here. But maybe you guys know. But I'm still a little bit puzzled why it doesn't pull 5 kilowatt from the socket. Why it's only pulling 3 kilowatts. But, now it's, right. But also I want to show you that right now on the display here, you see the little bacon over there. So that indicates that we are preheating, or we are using the heater. And also over here, you see that auxiliary climate is now active. So I've driven the i3 in the past, but I think I was kind of noob in the beginning. So every time I stop to charge, I just fire up the car like I do with most other cars, like let's say Ioniq or the Kia or something, and they would activate the heater while you're parked, but while you're charging. But I noticed that some cars like Zoe doesn't do this. It's the same behavior. When you're plugged in, it won't activate the heater here unless you use the remote or you use the app to activate it. And also the same for the e-Golf. When you're plugged in, same behavior there. But okay, anyway, let's just let it run for a little bit and see what happens. All right, it's been a while now, a long time, almost an hour or something. But I've been restarting the heater a little bit, and you see the status now, it's back to 100%. It says zero here, so it says the battery. This is probably input or output from the battery, and it's zero. The battery has not been heated up or cooled down a little bit. So it doesn't seem like the battery heater has run, but I bet it doesn't need to, because 13 degrees is nice. If it was zero, then maybe the battery heater would run. What I find interesting, well, is this one. You see, this is the charge unit outside, energy kick. It reports 4.5 amp pull, which is around 1 kilowatt, roughly. So it means that the preheating thing here is running 1 kilowatt. If we start it, Then you heard a little difference in intensity of the heater. I actually feel like when the preheating is running, it gets almost too hot sometimes. But yeah, okay, let's see now. Do we see any difference here? Huh. Interesting. It seems to have stopped. Yeah. But then the bacon is still active. But okay, anyway. So that was just a video about... Am I zoomed out? No. That was just a video about how you can preheat in an i3. And I just want to see if the battery heater kicked in or not. It didn't. Maybe I have to wait until it's cold enough if you guys want to see that action. So I will keep this car for a while. So I will do more experiments with it. Yeah, so anyway, that's going to be it for now. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you for watching and talk to you later.